We are in the golden age of solar eclipses, but only for the moment. In fact, I'd argue we're already past peak solar eclipse and it's all downhill from here. Let me explain. Solar eclipses are amazing phenomena, but they're also just like one object casting a shadow on another, which we see all the time. I think we're impressed by our current solar eclipses for a few key reasons. First, and obviously, they block the sun in the middle of the day, so it gets dark, cold, you can see stars, etc. Second, our eclipses aren't purely like night, either. The shadow of the moon is small enough that there's still sunlight falling on the atmosphere near the horizon, resulting in a deep blue sky and the appearance of a sunrise or sunset 360 degrees around you. Third, our current eclipses also reveal the sun's corona, the outer part of the sun's atmosphere that's much dimmer than the sun's bright disk and normally lost in the sun's glare. But when the sun's disk is covered during an eclipse, the corona appears like a bright starburst around the dark disk of the moon. Fourth, total eclipses are rare. Any given point on Earth only experiences about one total solar eclipse every several hundred years, so they're kind of a once-in-a-lifetime or less experience. Fifth, eclipses are fleeting. Totality typically only lasts a few minutes, which makes them feel even more precious and cosmic, and also doesn't give our human brains time to really process or take in the weirdness of what's happening before it's over. And finally, eclipses on Earth are also notable because they can be either total, where the moon fully blocks the sun and is spectacular, or annular, where the moon appears smaller than the sun and never completely obscures it. At best, there's still a ring, or annulus, of the sun visible, hence annular eclipse. Because they don't fully block the sun's disk, annular eclipses aren't really much more impressive than partial eclipses. The sky doesn't get deep blue, you don't see the corona, you can't look at them with your naked eyes, etc. They're cool, but are nothing like a total eclipse. It's kind of weird that we have both annular eclipses, where the moon appears smaller than the sun, and total eclipses, where the moon appears bigger than the sun. That both happen is due to the fact that the Earth and the moon's orbits aren't perfectly round, so the relative distances to the moon and sun change over time, and therefore so do their relative apparent sizes. But here's a sad fact. We have, on average, more annular eclipses than total eclipses. And that is why we are currently past the peak of the Earth's golden age of eclipses. The moon formed billions of years ago, and we have good reason to believe it was much closer to the Earth then than it is now. With the moon so close, it was much bigger in the sky. Total eclipses would have been much more common, and much longer and much darker. The moon's shadow would be so big that an eclipse would be much more like normal nighttime, rather than a deep blue sky with golden glow all around the horizon. The moon would also have been big enough to cover most of the sun's corona, and the moon would have been more illuminated with Earthshine, meaning a solar eclipse would probably feel kind of like a normal night sky, just with a darker than normal moon. Boring. However, for all the billions of years after the moon formed, the Earth was spinning faster than the moon was orbiting, as it still does. A day is shorter than a month. And so over time, tidal forces have transferred some of the Earth's rotational momentum to the moon, sending the moon farther and farther away. Up until around 700 million years ago, the moon was close enough to the Earth that it always appeared larger than the sun, and we only ever saw total solar eclipses. But around then, the moon finally moved far enough away from us that, at least during certain parts of the Earth's and moon's orbits, the moon appeared smaller than the sun in the sky. And if it appeared smaller than the sun during an eclipse, it wouldn't fully block the sun. You'd get an annular eclipse, not a total one. Initially, most eclipses would still have been total solar eclipses, with annular eclipses being rare. But as the moon continued to get farther and farther from Earth, annular eclipses became more and more common. Sometime in the last several hundred million years, we crossed a threshold to where the moon appears smaller than the sun on average. At that point, annular eclipses became more common than total eclipses. Fast forward to today, and there are around 20% more annular eclipses than total eclipses. And as the tides continue to transfer our angular momentum to the moon will continue to get farther from the Earth, annular eclipses will become more and more common, and total eclipses rarer and rarer. Until around a half billion to billion years from now, the last total solar eclipse will darken the sky on Earth, and the golden age of eclipses will be over. Let's hope it isn't cloudy. If you live in North America, the date of the last ever total solar eclipse is Monday, April 8th, 2024. Wait, no, that's just the next total solar eclipse as of the time of this video. And this video was supported in part by NASA's Heliophysics Education Activation Team, which loves solar eclipses. NASA HEAT's mission is to engage with learners of all ages like you and me, and to deepen our understanding of our closest star and its effects on Earth and the solar system. Solar eclipses are a great way to experience a different side of the sun than we normally do, like literally the corona extending out from its sides. If you ever have the opportunity to see a total eclipse, I highly recommend it. And NASA does too. Thanks to NASA HEAT for their support.